Is to grapple with the VAT taxes imposed on petroleum products. The Renaissance Insurance has warned of radical shift in inflation in the country. Now, the firm actually feels that the consequences of the fuel rise will be the rise in the prices of food in the country, which might drive the inflation 1 to 2% higher. The Independent Investment Bank, however, does feel that the country doesn't have to worry about the debts and should instead go out and borrow more to put into investments on electricity and education, which according to them are the key drivers of economies. They moreover welcomed the move by the government in the supplementary budget to slash spending, and they feel that the government is doing enough to prevent Kenya from going the Argentina way.
The country sticks to its reforms, and that's where the credibility comes in. If you follow the Ghana story, following the slashing of the deficit last year by 3 percentage points of GDP, that has certainly improved credibility. You've seen the currency stabilize on the back of that. If Kenya demonstrates the same without an IMF program, then we've got no need to be worried about the debt statistics as they stand.
It's not about financing government spending. Kenya has not been drawing on the facility from the IMF for a number of years. That's all telling us that we can be relaxed about the situation, and that Kenya, like Ghana, is moving in this regard kind of beyond aid, to take the president of Ghana's quote, and that's a good thing.